Good morning students, in the last class we derived the boundary condition between conductor and free space, right? In continuation with that, next let us derive dn at the boundary, that is electric flux density, normal component of electric flux density at the boundary. So it is dn at the boundary, dn at the boundary, right? So to derive the dn at the boundary, consider the same figure as we considered in the previous class, that is this figure, right? Here we are considering the closed Gaussian surface in the form of right circular cylinder. So this is a right circular cylinder whose top radius is in parallel with the bottom radius, that is the center of the top surface and the center of the bottom surface coincide with each other. Right, and the radius of the cylinder is nothing but the radius of the top surface or the radius of the bottom surface. So such a cylinder is called as the right circular cylinder. So consider this right circular cylinder with the height delta h and width delta w. So height of this cylinder is delta h, right, and we have top surface, bottom surface and the lateral surface. The height delta h by 2, half of the height is inside the conductor and half of the height delta h by 2 is in the free space. Okay, so now let us apply the Gauss law to this right circular cylinder. If you apply Gauss law to this right circular cylinder, we get, that is according to Gauss law, we have closed surface integral of d bar dot ds bar, this is equal to q. Closed surface integral of d bar dot ds bar is equal to q. So here for the right circular cylinder, as I told, we are dividing the surfaces into top surface, bottom surface and the lateral surface. Fine students. So here we have the total integral, the total surface integral is evaluated in terms of top surface, in terms of bottom surface and in terms of the lateral surface, that is side surfaces. So the area of top and bottom surface is equal to delta S. As I told, the area of top and bottom surface is equal to delta S. So here we have the total integral is given by top surface integral d bar dot ds bar plus the bottom surface integral of d bar dot ds bar plus the lateral surface integral, lateral surface integral of d bar dot ds bar, this is equal to q. This is equal to q. Take it as equation 2, this as equation 1. The bottom surface is the one in which it lies inside the conductor. The bottom surface lies inside the conductor. So we have assumed that the conductor is that is ideal conductor. So for the ideal conductor, the d bar electric flux density is 0, hence the corresponding integral also becomes 0, right? So this corresponding integral of the bottom surface, this becomes 0. Okay students, what about the top surface and the bottom surface? The top surface is in the free space, right, and we are working on the boundary conditions, right? So if you want the boundary conditions, then the delta h, this tends to 0. Delta h tends to 0 for the boundary condition, is it not? So if we consider this condition, then we have here the total integral now becomes top integral d bar dot ds bar plus lateral integral of d bar dot ds bar, this is equal to q. The previous equation was 2, so let us take it as equation 3. Lateral surface area of the cylinder area of cylinder or right circular cylinder, this is equal to 2 pi r into its height, that is delta h, where r is the radius of the cylinder, right? Where r is the radius of the cylinder, we want at the boundary condition, so delta h tends to 0. So as delta h tends to 0, so this area reduces to 0, because delta h is 0, so the area reduces to 0, and the corresponding integral also becomes 0. So the only component that is left, that is d bar component, is the normal component. Okay, because we have seen in the previous derivation, in our previous class, that the tangential component of electric flux density is 0, that is d tan equal to 0. So here we have only the normal component, that is dn, for the top surface. So for the top surface, as the surface is very small, so dn can be assumed constant on the top surface, and hence can be taken out of the integral sign. So like this, so we have top surface integral only, d bar dot ds bar. So this is equal to dn is constant, only normal component exists here, as tangential component is 0. So that is top area, that is ds bar. So this is equal to dn delta s. Take it as equation 4, because the surface area, top surface area and bottom surface area, we assumed as delta s. Fine. So from the Gauss law, we know that dn delta s is equal to q. Dn delta s is equal to q. Okay. So here, if we consider the surface charge density, then the equation can be written as q is equal to, in terms of surface charge density, rho s delta s. Rho s is charge per unit area, that is q divided by a. So a q divided by s and delta s will cancel. LHS equal to RHS, that is q is equal to q. Okay, so take it as equation 6. So here we have dn delta s is equal to q, and q is equal to rho s delta s. So we can equate dn delta s is equal to rho s delta s, correct? So we, by equating here, we get, let us equate those two equations. So what we get here, that is dn delta s, this is equal to rho s delta s. Delta s and delta s will cancel, so we get dn is equal to rho s. So this indicates that the normal component of the flux density is equal to the surface charge density. Normal component of flux density is equal to the surface charge density. Dn is equal to epsilon naught En or epsilon naught E. So this is equal to rho s. Therefore, the normal component of electric intensity is given by rho s upon epsilon naught. So this is our second formula. Then here, they have asked the boundary conditions between conductor and dielectric, right? So the dielectric, if it is air medium, that is free space, then we have epsilon naught, epsilon is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. So for free space, epsilon r is equal to 1. Therefore, we have only epsilon is equal to epsilon naught. But if the boundary is considered between conductor and the dielectric, then the formulas will be modified as, the conductor and the dielectric, we have E tan is equal to D tan is equal to 0. This is for the boundary between conductor and dielectric. Then we have the normal component dn, same as that of the boundary between conductor and free space. Okay, so dn is equal to rho s. And only En will change. En will be equal to rho s upon epsilon. Okay. So previously we had En is equal to rho s upon epsilon naught. So here will be for conductor and between conductor and dielectric boundary condition, it will be En is equal to rho s upon epsilon. So that is equal to rho s divided by epsilon naught into epsilon r. So these are the boundary conditions between conductor and dielectric. So these are the boundary conditions between conductor and the dielectric. Fine students, boundary conditions between conductor and the dielectric, between conductor and the dielectric. and director. So this was the question that was asked in the examination. Fine. Next, let us proceed in solving an example. Consider this example here. This example is given. So next question is the example, that is question number 4A. Given v is equal to 2x square y minus 5z at point P of -4, 3, 6. Find the potential, electric field intensity, electric field intensity, and volume charge density. Right. So given V is equal to 2x square y minus 5z at point P of -4, 3, 6, find potential, electric field intensity, and volume charge density. Right. So he has given the potential, but we have to find the potential at the specified point P of -4, 3, 6. So let us solve this. V is equal to 2x square y minus 5z. So we want at P of -4, 3, 6. So therefore V will be equal to 2 into x square is 4 square, x is minus 4 square into y is 3 minus 5 into z is 6. So if we simplify this, then we will get 66 volts. So the value of potential is 66 volts at the point P of -4, 3, 6. Then we have E bar is equal to minus del V. E is equal to minus del V. We know this formula. So that is minus of del V will be equal to dou V by dou X AX bar plus dou V by dou Y AY bar plus dou V by dou Z AZ bar. Dou V by dou Z AZ bar. So this is equal to minus of, so if we simplify dou by dou x of V, okay, that is if you differentiate V to x square y minus 5z with respect to x, then here we get, that is x square differentiation is 2x, so it is 4xy we will get here, 4xy, okay, 4xy ax bar, then with respect to x 5z it is 0, then next plus differentiation with respect to y, so y if we 2x square if we take it outside, so it will be y differentiation is 1, so plus 2x square ay bar, right, then minus 5, differentiation of this equation with respect to z is, so differentiation with respect to x square y is 0, so differentiation of minus 5z is minus 5, so this is minus 5 az bar, okay. So this is E bar equation. Then we have at point P, we want at point P. So as we want at point P, so this is given by E bar is equal to, now substitute the values here. That is, if you substitute the values of X, Y and Z in this equation, minus 4 of 4 into X is minus 4 into, that is a y is 3, right, plus 2x square, x is minus 4 square into ay bar minus 5 az bar. There is no z value here, so it is simply minus 5 az bar. So if we simplify this, then we'll get, on simplification, E bar equation will be given by E bar is equal to 48 plus 48 AX bar, okay, because if we consider here, so outside is minus, okay, inside is also minus, so minus into minus becomes plus, so it is 4 4 is 16, 3 is 48, correct? So 48 ax bar minus 32 ay bar plus 5 az bar volt per meter. Next we want d bar at point P. So d bar at point P is nothing but we have e bar at p into epsilon naught. Fine students, so that is if we multiply this e bar equation with epsilon naught, that is 8.854 it tends to minus 12, then we get d bar as 0.425. So this equation we have to multiply with 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12, that is epsilon naught value. So we get 0.425 ax bar minus 0.2833 ay bar plus 0.0442 az bar nano coulomb per meter square. It is nano coulomb. Okay, so this is entire into nano coulomb per meter square. Next we want the volume charge density. So rho v is given by the formula divergence of the electric flux density. Rho v is equal to del dot d bar as per the Gauss law in point form. So this is equal to dou dx by dou x plus dou dy by dou y plus dou dz by dou z. Okay, so this is nothing but here we get this as, so d is equal to epsilon naught e, correct? D is epsilon naught e, right? So if we substitute this, d is equal to epsilon naught into e. What is e? So our e is the basic equation, that is what we got for e bar. Fine students, this is our e equation, minus of 4xy ax bar plus 2x square ay bar minus 5 az bar, that is equation 1, right? If we multiply this equation 1 by epsilon naught and then substitute the values of x, y and z, so we get epsilon naught of minus 4y plus 0 here. Okay, so this will be equal to minus 4 epsilon naught y, okay, coulomb per meter cube. So it is volume charge density, so it is coulomb per meter cube. So next we want that value of this. So rho v at P, it is rho v is equal to minus 4 into y value is 3, so it is minus 4 into 3 into epsilon naught. So this comes out to minus 12 epsilon naught, or that is given by minus 0.1062 nano coulomb per meter cube. Okay, so I hope you all have understood how we got this. D is epsilon naught e. I am multiplying epsilon naught with e equation. Equation for e, that is equation 1. So then I have substituted the values of x, y and z. So then I get epsilon naught into minus 4y plus 0 plus 0. That is minus 4 epsilon naught y coulomb per meter cube. So if we want rho v at point P, so we have to substitute the value of y here. So we get minus 12 epsilon naught. So epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to minus 12. So that on simplification we get that is equal to minus 0.1062 nano coulomb per meter cube. Right students, so I hope everybody have understood the today's topics. The first topic was the DN at the boundary, and then we have solved an example to find the potential, electric field intensity and the volume charge density given the equation for the potential. Okay, so these were the today's topics, that is DN at the boundary. We have derived the boundary condition equation, right, boundary condition between conductor and the dielectric, and then we have solved an example to find potential electric field intensity and volume charge density. Okay, if there are any queries in these topics, send your queries to me. I'll clarify your queries. Thank you.